going on, you guys? This is Christian from Fuji Film here to showcase the new X100VI. Talking about all the new specs, body-wise, everything is pretty identical from the V. So any accessories like the converters, the leather case, and all that will still work. Even the adapter ring and the lens hood. Internally, though, we've upgraded from 26 megapixels to 40. We have the new processor, the new sensor. On top of that, we've added IBIS up to 6 stops. And then on the video side, we've really increased and went up to 6.2K at 30 frames, 4K 60, 1080p at 240. All of that is internal. We also have 422 10-bit. So you have a lot of capability for this for both photography and videography. It's a great hybrid.
Who is this camera for?
This camera is for everybody. So anybody that wants to do street photography, anybody that wants to do portraits, anybody that wants a B camera or main camera for video or for photos as a backup, it's really for everybody.
It's really nice. It's really nice. And what lens is attached to this here?
So this is our fixed 23mm f2.
Oh, nice. F2, I like it.
Yeah. So really low aperture. It goes all the way down to 2. You can control, of course, your aperture here. You can control your shutter speed. You lift this up. You control your ISO.
Very cool.
And then we got function buttons and all that to personalize it the way that you want to.
Awesome. And how would folks be able to get their hands on this? Can they test it out? What's going on?
Yeah, so any trade show events, we also have on our website where all the other tech reps are going to be for first look events. So like for myself, next week I'll be at Bedford Cameras at like 4 locations showcasing the 106. So keep an eye on our website or local dealers and we'll be there to showcase it. And yes, inventory has been greatly improved. We are sending thousands of these cameras to all of our local dealers here in the US.
And what are some of your favorite features of this camera yourself? What do you like?
Definitely the IBIS and definitely the video capability, because I'm more into the videography side. So for this being so tiny but having crazy specs up to 6.2K is nuts.
6.2K?
Yep.
And frames per second, what is it?
30 frames.
35?
30 frames.
Oh, 30 frames.
But
awesome.
Then you could do 4K at 60.
Oh, you
and
do
then 4K at 60.
Does it crop or no?
I believe it does a little bit of a crop.
A little bit? Okay.
Let me double check. Yeah. So let's see. So I can show you right here. We do all the way 4K at 16:9.
Oh, nice.
We do the 6.2K at 16:9 at 30. And this one will crop a little bit. So it says on the top.
Oh, okay.
So
oh, that's not bad.
Yeah. 1.33, nothing crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
And then if we do 4K 60. All right here. So this is a 1.14 crop. And then we could also do H.265, 422 MOV, all the way up to 200 megabits.
Hey, that's nice. Really nice.
Yep.
And have you tested out for video yourself? Or?
Yeah.
Oh.
No, for video, yeah, it's great. And then we also have the film simulations. And then you could do F-Log 2 internally as well,
oh,
which is really nice.
Oh, that's real nice, internal.
Yep. F-Log, F-Log 2, HLG.
Yeah, that's good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I like that. And
yeah.
Where do you see this in your bag? Like, why would you have this camera in your bag versus all the other ones you use?
Portability.
Portability?
Portability. It's honestly a smaller version of the X-T5, so I'm not really lacking or missing anything. So if I want to travel light, but not really limit quality or anything like that, that's when I'll take this.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much.
Yeah.
I appreciate it.
Definitely.